Howdy there, friends. My name is Glenn, and this is the Cactus Atlas. And today we're going to be seeking out an old cinder mine, volcanoes, and some lava tubes out in the middle of freaking nowhere, Mojave Desert. All right, so before we get started, Amy, I'm gonna ask you to do something special for our audience. Start off with a satellite view. From satellite views, you really start to see what's going on. If you zoom in far enough, to me, it looks like the surface of a planet like Io. One of the moons of Jupiter, I think, is the volcanic moon, right? Or is it Io? I think it's Io. Anyway, that's what this landscape looks like to me. It looks like another planet when you see it from satellite view. And we're gonna be driving right through the heart of it today as we seek out some really cool stuff. And to help us navigate through this episode today is our ever faithful Slim, my pickup truck, my 4x4 vehicle, very well suited with its heavy duty tires to cross the type of terrain that we're gonna be dealing with today. And I'm gonna get back in the truck here and I'll tell you a little bit about what I know as we make our way over to some of these sites today. I'm really excited. This is high up on my list of things that I've wanted to do and see in the preserve since it came onto my radar. So the hazards of today, other than just the pure remoteness of where we're at, I think would be driving through the fields of volcanoes that we're gonna be going through, mainly because this area is known for some pretty sharp volcanic rocks. So you definitely want heavy duty tires. Another hazard for some people, I guess it could be a hazard for me depending on the severity, but probably not, would be sand, like you're seeing here. The Mojave National Preserve is renowned for getting stuck in the sand and then having to get really expensive towing out of here. I've seen pictures of this, and usually when I see pictures, it's somebody that went in a passenger car and tempted the devil. I believe I see the signature of what looked like cinder cones, those bumps out on the horizon. So you think of that Google satellite view that we showed you, that's the area, like straight ahead of us, that looks like that. And I can already tell, you know, it's pretty devoid of vegetation, it looks like. So here's really maybe our first good look at the evidence of volcanoes here in the preserve. Right here, all this black volcanic rock, kind of reminiscent of Sunset Crater National Monument if you've been there in Arizona. I think there's some cinder cone action there, these like round reddish mounds. And over this hill, you can kind of see some poking up. We're gonna be going into the heart of this. So this is kind of the start of where the Google satellite image I wanted to kind of put up earlier. We're about to drive through the heart of that. So this is what it looks like from ground level. Some of those black flows you probably saw, I wonder, you could see it. Maybe these are old lava flows or something, and those are the black scars that you see from the air. Being down here at ground level, it's all covered in nice green Joshua trees and stuff. It doesn't look as desolate or barren, but wanted to at least stop here and give you your first look, and my first look too, of this beautiful terrain. And the pristine quiet out here in the preserve. I always remark on that, and it's one of my favorite things. Here you go. Here's what we've really come to seek out today. Cinder rock. I think this is a cinder. One of the products of cinder cones. It's very lightweight. It's like pumice stone type of stuff. But this is the kind of stuff they came out here to mine, as you're gonna see, mainly for landscaping rock type of stuff. But you could see it dotting the ground if you keep an eye out. There are some up on the road I meant to show you. Ejected from one of these things, who knows how long ago, if this was millions of years ago, thousands of years ago, I really don't know. I don't think anything's active anymore though. Look at that, here's some more. These are the heavier ones, I think, these black, oh yeah, this is really heavy. But this is that black volcanic rock and it is hot. That burns my fingers. And there's some more of the red. Like cinder rock, it's lighter. I don't know geologically the difference between the black rock, is that basalt? And this is, I don't know what the official scientific term is, but I assume they're different They're definitely different in quality and weight. Look at all that volcanic rock here. All left over from the relatively short-lived eruptions of all these cinder cones. It's kind of interesting how it just forms a wall here. My assumption is, over time, this wash and water carved out the side or something to expose that. I wonder if that's what it's like underneath our feet. But we're not in Hawaii. We're in the middle of the Mojave Desert. I'm done with the sun, it's hot. We're gonna head back to Slim, and we're gonna go see way better stuff than this. I hope, anyway. Pretty sure we are. Now, how do I get back to the car? But there you go, cinder cone volcano. I think extinct is the correct term to use. I don't think they're dormant, I think they're extinct. I didn't have a chance to do tons of research on this. I read a few factoids and that was about it. I see a road going up on the side of this, so that's probably a pretty good sign that we're not far, and we only have 1.1 miles to get to the mine itself, according to Google, so we are very close. And if you don't know what to expect here, I think you're gonna be pleased most likely with what you see. This is a kind of a cool thing, and in some ways reminiscent of the fate of Gold Dome Mill, if you've seen that episode. An operation that was just left here in the desert to, I was gonna say rust with time, but I wouldn't say rust out here, to just sunbake with time. Alrighty, we're gonna drive up the side of a volcano here. Once we get on foot, I'll tell you some more factoids about things that I read. A little bit about volcanoes, a little bit about the mine we're gonna go find here. Because you're probably wondering, why the heck would they want a mine up here on a volcano? It wasn't gold, it wasn't silver, it wasn't metal even that they were mining here. They were mining rock, volcanic rock. So you could see Aiken Mine here right in front of us, a cinder mine, the remnants of it. On public land, by the way, this is not private. I'm not trespassing, 100% legit. Even the Mojave National Preserve website calls this place out as a place to visit. So if you're wondering why I'm here, that's why. But anyway, on this back side of the volcano, you could see they really did a number on it. Like, and you can see what they were up to. They were just mining all these small volcanic rocks out of it. And in fact, one interesting thing I read is out of all the cinder cones here, there's not a single one of them today that is not blemished like this. And that's really unfortunate, because the reason why they did that back in the day wasn't because they had to, because they weren't really mining them all. I think to claim them, they had to have evidence that they were doing something. So companies would come in here and just dig just to do that. And then they never mined it. So I think in the state of California, if I read correctly, there's only one like pristine, untouched cinder cone left. I forget where it is. I think it's in SoCal somewhere, but you will find no pristine ones here. But we're cutting right into the volcano. That's kind of cool, isn't it? And look at all that rock. And here it is, the beautiful Aiken Mine. Well, it's behind me, but this is the start of it that we're looking below from this view. When I say beautiful, it's kind of mixed. I mean, it's man's doing, but I think we're gonna have fun with this one though. So driving up here, you know, I saw these tunnels and assume mine shafts of some sort. You got conveyor systems that come out there. I guess maybe at one point trucks were pulling up here and they were just dumping the rock in, but you know, there's much left behind. I don't know if they can, if that's ever going to be in demand enough to warrant doing it. But when I see how much industrial equipment is just left here to rot with time, you know, it makes me think that it wasn't a profitable thing, but it did have a run, so, and it did have a purpose. These are really interesting lime green bushes. I don't know what those are, but they like to grow on this slope, and it's kind of aesthetically pleasing. Some of you might remark right off the bat, like, heck, this looks a lot like landscaping rock, like my neighbor's landscaping. I've seen, don't see a lot of this in Phoenix, but in Las Vegas, this mine served Las Vegas well. and apparently supplied the city with much of its landscaping rock of the time. So if you live in Vegas and you have a neighbor, or maybe you're walking down the strip one day and you see something like this, maybe you should wonder, is this the origin of where the rock came from? I think this stuff is formed, you know, these cinder cones I read are relatively short-lived for volcanoes. They kind of crop up, explode, eject, this kind of thing. I think this rock had a lot of gases in it and stuff, and there's a lot of pores in it, probably why it's so light. It really is very light. I don't think it's the kind that will float on water or anything, but very light compared to that black basalt rock. Here's some of that again. Right down here, I bet you this chunk's heavy. So probably less gaseous. I don't know what, like in the volcanic terms, why some of it comes out that black basalt looking rock and why some of it's that reddish stuff, but it probably has to do with the gases and stuff like that. But basically this is a big volcano that was burping up all of this stuff. So I don't even know, like with this type of mining, I don't really expect to find mine shafts and stuff like that. I think they just dug right into the side of the thing. And I guess this to me is the only curiosity. Seeing the conveyor belts and stuff there, I wonder if they fed it down. Maybe there are bigger chunks and they had to break it down like a mill. But like I said, it would make sense. Maybe these tunnels were built and then they dropped the rock in and it came out on a conveyor system, dumped in the trucks, and then taken to the local landscaping company or whoever's buying it, I guess. So my dilemma is I have some obsession for whatever reason with mining. Maybe not this type of mining, but I have really been enjoying exploring old and abandoned industrial complexes because they're fascinating. It's amazing to see what man is capable of. There's something admirable about it in a way, but you know, so part of me is like, well, if they did clean it up, if they did get rid of it, it wouldn't be as fun. I wouldn't be making a video here today, but the other side is, why is it okay? This is where I could really use some comments down below if you know a little bit about this, but my guesses are the government came in to make this a national preserve and just kicked everybody out. And because of that, they're like, eh, you know, we're not gonna penalize you and make you clean your crap up. Or if it was before that, maybe it was that the company went bankrupt and they couldn't afford to do anything, which that wouldn't please me to hear that. That would be a little upsetting. All right, we are right on top now of where we just were down below. I'll take a peek over the edge here, and you can see a lot of those little volcanoes all over the landscape here. Over there too, a bunch of these things, and we're really getting to see this thing dissected, you know? I'm almost afraid to get too close to the edge of this thing. Wowzers, look at that. Look at all of that rock, cinders. And there's those conveyor systems that I'm guessing this is what fed those. And when I see things like that, it makes me think they dumped rock into that funnel, crushed it up and processed it maybe a couple times to get the nice sized chunks, I guess, that you would want for landscaping and stuff like that. I've seen this exact kind of landscaping rock before, many a time. I don't see it that often anymore, but it should be a familiar sight to most of us. And I'm guessing the processing of this stuff wasn't quite as intensive as something like gold. Like here's a crusher, it looks like, of some sort. I think the goal would probably be just to crush it up into small enough pieces. They didn't have to extract metals from rock and all of that stuff in the chemical treatments, I would think. I'm guessing it was just chop them up, ship them off, hot and fresh. This is a monstrous machine. No wonder they just left it here, man. Like, this thing's gotta be insane to transport and get out of here. Think of how they probably had to haul. I'm assuming they didn't assemble it on site, so they probably had to have really large trucks taking these giant loads up this treacherous road up here. See, that's the kind of stuff that I think is cool, to think of that. It's like achievement. You know, just like at Gold Dome too, like even the, assume it's rubber. Yep, even these things, it's surprisingly pliable after sitting in the hot sun and being a black colored thing. You think it would be all dried up and rotted, but maybe it's industrial strength. Yeah, I'm guessing that's exactly what that was. Just take the rocks up here and dump them off into the trucks. Oh, look at that. I saw a picture of this thing, Welcome Home Troops, when I was looking on the internet. So there's where that is. It's on the top of the hill. I think on the inside it looked like some kind of power room or something to control the electrics here. Dance Emma Goldman. I don't know what that means, but I saw some similar stuff, actually. I'm trying to keep my eye out for stuff that, you know, I don't like. But it's Gold Dome Mill. They had a thing that I don't know if we put it in the video or not, but a lot of, like, contraptions like this. Over there, it was much more hardcore, and it was very close to the conveyor system, so I guess these were, I don't know if these were fuses or what, but there's lots, and it's just still here. I'm sure vandals and people over time probably ripped out stuff, took the copper, you know, things like that. I've heard there was some vandalism here and theft over time of stuff, if you want to call it theft, I guess. Theft in cleaning up the environment could, in this case, be comparable statements. So if you don't like industrial equipment, I guess this might not be your thing. Maybe you don't like volcanoes either, so I sincerely apologize about today's episode if that's the case. But I like to surmise and wonder, like, 100 years from now, like, when I go to seek out places, when I'm dead and gone, will people still be seeking this out, and will all of this stuff still be here in a relatively good condition, and what will they be saying about it then? And this might support my theory of those being crushers of some sort, because over here, closer to this side, you could see the rocks are much larger. Those would not be good lit for landscaping in that form, I don't think. And there's another cinder cone. I almost see like a mining road that goes up the side and where they dug some things out. And I think that might be what I've read, where companies, for whatever reason, to claim it, or I guess to say, hey, we're gonna eventually mine it, would go up and dig a little bit. Not that they were gonna use it, but they did that and they scarred all of these, like every single one of them, for that reason. Chances are, though, if I drove up to the top of that hill, I bet you we'd see some kind of crater-like depression at the top of that. This one, it's probably long gone. It probably was dug out. They moved a lot of material, though, if you really think of the volume. If you kind of use that as the top of the mountain, and it probably came down and sloped back down this way, we're standing probably in a place that would have been underground before they started mining this, I would think. I would say that this, along with Gold Dome Mill, would be a great pairing if you like mining history. I would say industrial mining of somewhat recent times, and you like to explore industrial equipment, you are free to do so. All right, so now that I am kind of setting up a layup, or I'm setting us up for a slam dunk, as we head to our next location. And what I mean by that is I wanted you guys to get a good look at volcanism, evidence of volcanism in this area. And I don't think I could have done a better job than taking you into a cross section of a volcano to get things started. Now that that's been said, our next and final location, I would say the grand finale, is more volcano action.
In 500 feet, sharp left.
Alrighty. And yeah, it's gonna be awesome. I'm gonna just play along for a second, and you'll get a couple more views of this cinder cone. So really what I would say is we're gonna really get into the innards here of volcanoes in about 11 minutes, it says, 2.9 miles. We're very close to the final destination. Although I don't like to say it that way, final destination, that's not, if it's like the movie, that is not good. This part's really rocky, and you got the sharp rock here. And just staying on the road, I think, is the best policy. Man, this road is horrible. Yeah, you would not attempt this, I would say, in a passenger vehicle for sure. I'm even worried with Slim and the tires. driving on this. Maybe I need to relax more, I don't know. I think the worst of the off-roading will be over when we get to our destination, because the destination is definitely more touristy. And I wouldn't be surprised if we ran into some people. Although, like I said, with the heat, let's check the current temperature. 95 degrees. So interestingly, I started, it was like 90 degrees at 7 in the morning, and it's only gotten to 95. So I'm wondering if it's going to be as hot as I was thinking. But there's a lot of day. It's only 11:45 a.m. It's not even noon yet. So are we going to see 110 or more out here today? It very well could be. That's a little tricky. The road I want is called Lava Tubes.
Continue on Lava Tubes for half a mile.
Oh, Google, are you going to take me somewhere absolutely nutso? Please don't. And this looks okay so far, but I just have bad memories of the Gold Dome Mill Day. I mean, it wasn't that bad. I probably exaggerate a little bit, but there's a really obvious, easy way in to get somewhere that is just stupid easy. Direct, flat, easy. Anybody can do it. And when I plotted the route with Google, not only did it not take me that way, it passed it, took me all the way the hell around this mountain onto this other side to take this road that is clearly not used anymore. It was almost barely recognizable as a road in places. So that's why I get a little nervous with her. And sometimes it's like, oh, I'm gonna take you around this area probably because it's a dangerous road, or, you know, might be closed off, and it has good awareness of that. And then at other times, man, it's like it's smoking something. Well, I guess I got the answer to one of my questions is, are we going to run into other folks? Doubtful. I didn't see any coming in. I actually overshot our destination. I'll explain why in a second. I was unsure of something, but I am in the right spot. So, but this is the area of the famous lava tubes, or maybe not famous, but the lava tubes here in the Mojave National Preserve. And you could see a lot of that basalt and like these giant red cinder rocks. And this is the tourist way in for normal people. I think regular cars can make this road out to the main road with no problem, pretty sure. But now I understand when people say don't really drive beyond it. Like for a lot of you people coming here, you probably see the sign that says Lava Tube Trail. I wouldn't call that a trail as so much as the mine road, because that actually is the road I took to get from here to the Aiken Mine. And this last section is really where the sharp rock is, or when I drove through it, or was, or is. And here's a sign indicating we're at least going the right direction. So we do have to walk a little ways, though. I was kind of pondering, do I just turn around and drive back up here? But you can see this is the kind of stuff people talk about that can slash a tire easily. I think the top of this hill somewhere approximately is where we're going. Somewhere here are lava tubes. Like a lava cave, pretty small compared to other ones that I've read about or seen pictures of or videos, but still pretty cool. All right, here's a post, trail post. Hopefully it's like right here. No, oh, you know what? Here's where Google was telling me to turn. No vehicles anyway, so I did the right thing. Now you understand, I'm like, what? Maybe she wanted me to park over there or something, I don't know. Very strange, and very strange to think there's a lava cave here. One would not think that. There's like a hole. This might be the hole that brings light down there. I think it is. I think we're gonna be deep in there in a moment. It's pitch black. Oh, scary. It is kind of spooky. Alrighty, we made it. Oh, is there a stairs? Look at that. Look at that. That is so cool. I guess, I don't know if it, I think it might swing back to the left here. Not sure if it goes in both directions. I'm not sure if snakes like to hang out in these things either. It's a little worrisome. But I think this is the main way in, based on a couple photos I've seen. This is almost like a vertical ladder. Almost would be better going facing the other way, going down this thing. Whoa, this is awesome. Very neat. Hopefully it's cool in there too, because it is hot all of a sudden. So I think that's where we want to go. All right, Probably bats in here too, I would have to imagine. Whoa. Yeah. I think there's a tight squeeze and then it'll open up. So yeah, I have seen videos and stuff. I lied if I made it sound like I'm completely oblivious here, but it's been a long time. I didn't freshen up my knowledge. Lava cave, lava tubes, yeah. So this is what I think I've seen other people do. Oh yeah, we could probably get through here. It's just the ceiling is really sharp. It would hurt if I hit my head or my back. I'm not completely on my hands and knees, but I'm rubbing my back up against it. It does hurt. Ay, ay, ay. You can tell it's very well traveled though. If you look at the ground, it's flat, a little dusty, but this is the Mojave National Preserve lava cave. So there is light in here and it's beautiful. Oh my God, look at that. All right, now I don't need you. This is the part where you turn off. I'm getting mad at my stuff. It is lit up beautifully. So this is a very big draw, I would say, to the preserve. I think that's the hole we were looking down. And we are in this cave. And you got beams of light every so often in here. This is beautiful. Look at that. If we made it more dusty in here, maybe we could get beams to show. Or maybe there's depending on the time of day, there's a thing that points to a treasure map. Where the location of an old mine exists that nobody has found yet. Man. This is totally like something from an Indiana Jones film, isn't it? All right, I may have kicked up some more dust on purpose to get this to show up better when I was standing over there. And I think that's the trick. You just gotta move some dust around. Look how well pronounced that is though. That is so cool. So yeah, this really, I think, hopefully ties into our theme today, the volcanic theme, the cinder cone theme, because this would have been formed by lava at some point coming through this tube. And who knows how many of these things might be buried underground here, maybe miles of them, I don't know. I know in Flagstaff we have one that I've not done yet. I wanna do the lava tubes up there. I think those go back a mile in pitch blackness and cold. This one is cooler. It actually feels awesome. Like if I were a native, maybe one of the Mojave Indian tribe back in the day, I would have lived in this thing for sure. I wonder if there's evidence of human habitation at any point in history in here. You get free air conditioning, but a dusty trade-off for sure. I would say if you can get out here in midday, it's probably right about noon, late July. So I know the days are, things are timed differently than other times of the year. So don't quote me on this, but if it's July and it's around noon, that's all I can tell you is you get to see these cool phenomenon and it looks like it moves quickly because I see like a second patch of light starting, a second beam. And that one seems to be getting smaller in the background. So I don't know what window, no pun intended, of time you have to witness this phenomenon, but this is the thing that really made it. I was not expecting something this good, to be honest, the beams of light like that. Well, folks, I'm gonna leave you here on this episode in this wonderful lava cave. This was the final stop. Check it off the box. I hope you had fun. I really enjoyed exploring the volcanic side of the Mojave Desert. Did you even know this existed? Not sure, but now you do. And I gave you some things that you can come seek out for yourself when you can. With that, see you next week.